I'm Dr. Janet Trong, the current principal of Huron High School. It is my pleasure to welcome you to Huron High School's 50th anniversary celebration concert. Thank you to our superintendent of schools, Dr. Janice Swift, for joining us this evening. I would also like to acknowledge Ann Arbor Board of Education trustees who are here this evening, Trustee Patricia Manley and Trustee Harmony Mitchell. I would also like to introduce the other members of Huron's current administrative team. Please stand when I point you out. Assistant Principals Marcus Edmondson. Michael Summerton, Bobby Davis. And ninth grade Dean Tracy Stevenson. Also in the audience this evening are former Huron principals. I would like to recognize Dr. Arthur Williams. Additionally, joining us is Joyce Hunter, former Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Education. I believe I also see Dr. Ginny Bell, former Assistant Principal of Huron. Also sitting back there is Larry Didmar, also a former Huron music. Tonight, I also have the distinct honor to introduce former superintendent of schools from 1967 to 1971, Dr. Scott Westerman. And certainly the audience is filled with Huron alumni, as well as current and former Huron staff members who have joined us to celebrate Huron's 50th anniversary. If you are a Huron alumni, please stand up for a moment so we can welcome you. Thank you. Thank you. You can have a seat. If you are a former or a current Huron staff member, would you please stand up so we can acknowledge you? Superintendents, Board of Education trustees, assistant superintendents, principals, staff, alumni, current students, and parents have contributed to the legacy and have shared in the rich history of Ann Arbor Huron High School. As you likely know, Huron High School's first graduating class was in 1968. We will celebrate our 50th commencement on June 6, 2018. Recently, Karen Isley, our building and district chair for career and technical education, spent some time with the architect of our school, Keith Weiland, who is 92 years old and resides in Ann Arbor. Mr. Weiland shared that Huron opened its doors in September 1969. Huron was scheduled to have opened earlier, however, due to delays, the planned opening date was pushed back 2 years from 1967 to 1969. Huron was built in just 1 year. Huron is shaped like an H, with two convex wings adjoined by an archway that has become a distinguishing feature of the building. Mr. Weiland shared the reason the building has an arch is because as they were doing soil tests, there were only two spots available that would withstand the weight of a building, and we all thought this was just a unique design. In 1968, before Huron's building was completed, Eastside students who would attend the new high school shared the Pioneer building in a split schedule. Pioneer students attended classes in the morning from 7:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. and Huron students in the afternoon from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. In July 1969, Paul K. Myers, the first principal of Huron High School, and assistant principal Albert Gallup and staff moved in. He left the position in 1986. And from 1986 to 1987, Al Gallup served as an interim principal. In 1987, Huron saw Dr. Joanna Mile begin her tenure as principal, which she served until 1993. After Dr. Joanna Mile's departure from 1994, Jane Johnson served as interim principal. In 1994, Dr. Arthur Williams began his tenure at Huron. Dr. Williams retired with the class of 2014, and by serving as principal for 20 years, he becomes Huron's longest serving principal. During the 2014-15 school year, Jennifer Hines served as principal, followed by my tenure as principal, which began in 2015. Anyone who has ever attended or worked at Huron knows that we are fiercely proud of our mascot, the River Rat. Before the school opened, Ann Arbor High School students who were not going to be relocated to Huron came up with the name River Rat. They used the name as a joke to refer to the newly rival classmates who would attend a school built near the Huron River. Soon, Huron students turned the joke around, and they too began proudly referring to themselves as River Rats. However, administration felt differently about the River Rat. The nickname was ignored for the most part, and when Huron's construction was completed, the River Rat was not running in the running as a mascot. When Huron opens its doors in 1969, its mascot was intended to be the Huron. However, this mascot received little student support. Shortly after its opening, Huron had a write-in student ballot to determine a few choices for a possible alternative mascot. Several of the more popular choices included Highlanders, the Hawks, and the Indians, and these were put on the ballot during the student elections that year. The River Rat never made it to the ballot. None of the listed mascots, however, received 50% of the votes, and students kept writing in River Rat instead of selecting a given choice on the ballot. However, Huron went on for several years without a mascot, during which time local newspapers started referring to Huron sports teams by the old nicknames. Baseball players became Bat Rats, and wrestlers became Mat Rats. It was the media that validated the name River Rats. Over time, the name eventually stuck and became ingrained in Huron's history, resulting in the mascot, the Huron River Rats. In 1988, the Board of Education passed a $31 million renovation and construction program for Huron High School. From 1988 to 1991, Huron underwent major renovations in which the library and lunchrooms were enlarged, science and math rooms were added, and so was the band room. The athletic wing additions included a new pool and the lower gym. On May 12, 1993, the very auditorium we gather in this evening was dedicated to Paul K. Myers, Huron's first principal. Huron High School has developed a reputation as a high academic performing school. According to U.S. News, Huron is currently ranked number 29 within the state of Michigan. This year, we are exceedingly proud of our 28 students who are national merit finalists, semifinalists, placing us as number 5 in the state. Huron High School has also become an international baccalaureate school, fully authorizing the middle years program for grades 9 and 10, and the diploma program for grades 11 and 12. We are also a candidate school this year for the IB career-related program. I imagine that there is no coincidence that the International Baccalaureate is also celebrating their 50th anniversary worldwide this year. Huron also has a Grammy award-winning music program with our orchestras, bands, and choirs, receiving numerous accolades, awards, and praise over the many years. Additionally, over the years, our school has had a strong athletic program with 32 sports offerings, more than the University of Michigan. While the historical facts about Huron High School will speak to enrollment numbers, academic programs, brick and mortar, offices and classrooms, anyone who has ever attended Huron or worked here knows that it's really not about the architecture of our school or our mascot that makes us unique. Rather, it is the hard beliefs of Huron that make us truly unique. Huron High School is a diverse school. Our halls are filled with 1,626 students from many religious and ethnic backgrounds. At Huron, all are welcome. Our diversity is one of our most celebrated strengths. Huron High School is a family, one very big family. Once you are a River Rat, you are a River Rat for life. You become a lifelong member of Huron's high school family. Welcome home this evening. It is good to see you. Enjoy this evening's concert celebration. Happy 50th anniversary, Huron.